never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. Alfic.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Good. Now put my lips to the horn. That statue made in honor of Thor, and seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me. Why, you? He knows the pain of your loss. He will help you. Curious.
What is it?
Nothing to be concerned about.
What is he doing?
Making sure we're headed in the right direction. Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
That one of the people we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment there.
Now that, you thought I said you were friends of Odin. No, forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Nightmares, ugh! What awful pests!
Behind you! Incoming fire! I'm getting the hang of this.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Another map. Bet we'll find something useful here.
Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
Hey, Sindri. Have you met Mimir?
If you mean the severed head that keeps blinking at me, please, keep it away.
There is no possible way that's hygienic.
Oh, that's nice. Lovely to see you too, Sindri.
Nob.
Why? Is that a piece of my braided mistletoe arrow adorning your quiver strap? Oh, a little memento of your good pal, Sindri? I'm so terribly touched. Let's do it.
Oh, nothing. Okay.
I can do whatever you need. Master Atreus, how may I serve? Something else for you, then? And what can I do for you? What did we miss? If you're not in a hurry.
Where should we go? Now where should we go? I don't know what we're still doing here.
Poor Fafnir. There's a fine line between ambition and greed, you know.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances. And not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. But I can just tell you this story later.
Gulfig. You were taken from this realm too early.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead past this gate.
Skill continues to grow.
Midgard suffers. Deprived of your power, my dear Gulvig.
You who walks among the living! My beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've
lost. Really?
How? Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death. If only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
while... Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone.
Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person who didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamyr fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
Enemies. A wolver. Are we doing this?
Tip of one, yes. Very, very giant chisel.
Roma! Darn. That didn't seem to do anything.
Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again. Rick, lad.
Thanks. His idea. What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
Thank you.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles up ahead. What should we do? An all-fine light crystal. Wonder what it's for.
Read it.
Yes, sir. To Njord, we offer back the sea's bounty.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
Hardened World retrieves that. That's handy.